Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. Last week I visited the Doncaster Model Engineering Show and came away with a bargain. I'll show you that later. I also had a parcel of aluminium, some plate aluminium cut to sizes that I asked for, because I decided to remake my rotary head, which I used on the lathe and on the CNC machine, and now I want to make it to be used on the milling machine. But being made out of NDF, it's not strong enough to be clamped down to the table and give a good hold without the NDF crushing. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Last week I went to the Doncaster Model Engineering Exhibition at the Doncaster Racecourse, and I purchased a micrometer, this one, standard more and right, metric, and that cost me £5. This box is a rotary head, dividing head, whatever you want to call it. It's electronic. This end, it's just a protector. The thread on here and the spindle on here matches the Boxford lathe, so it's got the same thread as the lathe. I think that's 1.5 diameter register. More taper in the end. So all the equipment I have on my Boxford regarding chucks, 3-jaw chuck, 4-jaw chuck, collets, will all fit onto this. The only thing I need to adjust for a collet is the length of the drawbar for holding the collet into the spindle. So this one I made about 3 years ago, 4 years. It was a experimental one, so it was made in MDF. I copied the lathe spindle because that gives advantages of not having to purchase other parts. On the end there is the electrical connection on the end of the spindle. So if I take this out, this is just a small extension to the cable so I can remove the back completely. The back has just got the socket for the motor. So inside here we have a tooth pulley, two tooth pulleys and a tooth belt, and this is a tensioning device which came off a car cam belt adjuster that's just been modified to do this. I thought this sort of dividing head would come in handy, but obviously for a mill MDF is not strong enough to clamp down, so if I'm machining steel, a bit more force on it. So I've decided to remake this in aluminium and add a few more features on it. The first one being, I found that having the plug on the bottom was a disadvantage, because this head, it can, if you look at the spindle, it's offset. This was made for the lathe, so I could clamp it to the cross slide, and then by moving it on the correct side and clamping it down, it would put the chuck in line with the headstock on the lathe. Come in handy on the mill as well. And I'll make virtually a replica of this, but being in aluminium, I don't need 20mm thick sides. I can get away with 10, and that means it'll be slightly smaller. So what we have is a spindle and a bearing on this end. The spindle goes straight through to here. We've got two nuts and tooth pulley there, and the motor, stepper motor, is located inside. The only thing holding the front panel inside here is the pressure between the two bearings to hold the spindle. The first job is to take this apart. Just put some 4mm drills in the hole and put the drill in there to lock the spindle. It's not tight, so now I can remove the screws. I And this is on a cam, so as I turn the cam you can see the belt has come loose. In fact, I can take this out completely. This is just a bearing with an offset hole. So as you turn this round, it pulls the bearing in and out, tightens the belt up. That's the belt. Just this hole at the back here goes through into the hole where the grub screws are. Now the grub screws are on the other side of the pulley. So if I take the two grub screws off, slacken them off, there we go. There's the grub screws right on the edge. So now the spindle will come out through the front. Hole in that locks it. See, it's just a bearing recessed in the front board. And we've got the stepper motor inside. Cable, the other pulley that matches the first one. These blocks stop the bearing pulling through the board, because being MDF, if there's nothing behind there and you put force on the bearing to pull it in, it would just go into the hole. But with these blocks it gives it something to stop, butt up against, and stops it crushing the MDF. The stepper motor has a part number on there, but it's a 3.1 newton meter motor. Bearings are SKF bearings. I purchased bearings that have a seal, so any dirt and bits doesn't get into the bearing. Parcels arrived. This is the plate aluminium for the replacement. Two pieces for top and bottom, two pieces for the two sides. They're all 10mm thick aluminium. Two pieces that are 15mm thick. I've just noticed outside that the blue tits are back in the nest box. This is the second year they've returned, so it shows we're well into spring now. I've put some parallel strips on the table, and these strips are to hold the plate off the table so I can go below the edge of the material without cutting into the table. I'm putting the long edge onto the outside of the table like that. I'll clock this edge up true, and then I'll machine this edge to give a better finish, and then I'll move to the back of the table and machine that edge while this is still held in position, so I have two edges that are parallel. Now what I've done is I've moved the cutter from the front of the workpiece and gone to the back. I know this front edge is parallel and to the table, so now I'm going to machine the back edge and do exactly the same, put a 5mm by 5mm cut out on the end. I've machined the back and I've machined the front. Now I need to turn it round and square up the other two ends. When I've done that on the four plates that make the outside of the box, I can then start to machine the slots across for the dividers. I'm clocking this side up to zero so I know it's true to the machine axis. Then I'll machine this face to give a better finish than the sawn off piece, and put a 15mm wide slot in there, same as this, 5mm deep but 15mm wide for the end piece. This is the first plate that I've nearly finished. It just needs the back part finishing. I've done the front and the two sides, and I've machined a 15mm slot at the end and another 15mm slot in the middle. And the way they're slotting together, if I show you one with the plate that's half done, that fits into the other piece like that. Then when I've milled a 15mm slot up this side and level with the one in the middle, the 15mm thick piece will fit into there and one in the middle. So each side interlocks with the other side. Then to hold them together, all I'll do, a screw through the side, one screw in each side holding the 15mm piece, and then the compression on the bearings pulling the spindle in on the back plate here will hold it in position, and then the back door will just be a push fit in. I'm coming along quite well with that. If I show you on the prototype, 15mm slots will be all the way around. You can see on the corner down here they interlock, and then the spindle, the front face panel, just goes in, and then the bearing, when it pulls from the other side, pulls that panel in. And on the other side, this is a fixed panel. It's got a slot all the way around and it can't move backwards or forwards, so the two bearings tighten up on each other and compress the box together. And then the door on the back just goes in to keep the dirt out. Well, that's it for today. Hope that's interesting, and I hope to see you next time on Enots Engineering.